हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 27। व्हाट्सएप इज रिपोर्टेडली वर्किंग टू इंक्रीज द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ इट्स क्लाउड बैकअप्स विद अ न्यू पासवर्ड प्रोटेक्शन फीचर दैट विल एनक्रिप्ट चैट बैकअप्स, मेकिंग देम एक्सेसिबल ओनली टू द यूजर। व्हाट्सएप बीटा इन्फॉर्म रिपोर्टेड ऑन द वर्किंग प्रोग्रेस ऑन दिस फीचर फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर एंड टुडे इट शेयर्ड फ्यू स्क्रीनशॉट्स ऑन हाउ इट कुड बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन द सर्विसेज ऑफ iOS एंड एंड्रॉइड एप्लीकेशंस। SafeJob is a company that launches Seco app, a short video platform for jobs and learning. This application is a TikTok for learning and Tinder for jobs that was set by co-founder Divya Jain. Kais, a digital marketer and customer service outstanding firm, has set up its first center in Hyderabad and it is looking to hire 750 to 800 people this year. OnePlus 9 series with all new Hasselblad cameras to officially launch on March 23rd. The regular and pro models are expected to pack Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 processor and OnePlus 9 Pro is set to feature quad rear camera. OnePlus commits to investing $150 million on camera development over next 3 years to further build out its mobile imaging capabilities in its ongoing pursuit of delivering the best smartphone camera experience for its users. Through close warranty collaboration, OnePlus and Hasselblad will work together to deliver vastly improved camera systems on future OnePlus smartphones, including the upcoming OnePlus 9 series. For last 80 years, Hasselblad has pioneered high-performance camera technology to become recognized as a world leader in digital medium format cameras and lenses. As per the recent leaked Twitter post, the OnePlus 9 Pro may feature quad rear camera sensors with 48-megapixel primary sensor camera, 50-megapixel of ultra-wide angle camera and 8-megapixel of telephoto lens and 2-megapixel of depth sensor camera. They also revealed that it comes with 16-megapixel of front-facing camera. In response to fan questions, OnePlus CEO Pat Liu directly confirmed that the company's next flagship, OnePlus 9 series, will still include a charger in the box. Oppo F19 Pro and Oppo F19 Pro Plus 5G launched in India with AMOLED display, 48-megapixel quad camera and more. Oppo F19 Pro Plus 5G specifications include 6.43-inch AMOLED display, MediaTek Dimensity 800U chipset and a 65W charging. Oppo F19 Pro specifications are Helio P95 processor, 30W charging and 48MP quad camera. Oppo F19 Pro Plus comes with 8GB RAM and 128GB variant with 25,990 rupees. Oppo F19 Pro comes in two variants, 8GB RAM and 128GB storage is available at ₹21,490 and 8GB RAM and 256GB storage variant is available at ₹23,490. Oppo has launched its new fitness band, the Oppo Band Style in India, along with that Oppo F19 Pro series. As a promise, it has 1.1-inch AMOLED color screen. It comes with 12 sport modes including fat reduction mode when running. The band supports 5 ATM water resistant that can take it for swimming under 50 meters and the company promises up to 12 days of battery life. Oppo Band Style comes in black and vanilla colors and the price is at ₹2,999. As an introductory price, it is available at ₹2,799 till March 23rd on Amazon.in. Vivo X60 global launch date is on March 22, according to the Vivo's Malaysia official website. The global Vivo X60 and Vivo X60 Pro variants will run Snapdragon 870 chipset instead of Exynos 1080. Vivo will launch the Vivo X60, Vivo X60 Pro and Vivo X50 Pro Plus in India. Xiaomi teases the launch of Redmi Smart TV in India on March 17th. Redmi recently launched the Redmi Max 86-inch Ultra HD TV in China. It also launched its first TV in China, the Redmi Smart TV 98-inch last year. Xiaomi says that new Redmi device will deliver excel experience and that is going to launch in India. Motorola has launched its 4K Android TV stick with built-in Chromecast features. It comes with 2GHz Cortex A53 68-bit processor. It will go on sale via Flipkart later this month. It has around 2GB of RAM and 16GB of storage. It could be priced at ₹3,999. Samsung Galaxy A52 Live Images seems to be leaked on Twitter. This phone is looks similar to A32. There are some leaked images in Twitter suggest that Samsung A72 would come with 6.7-inch Full HD Plus Super AMOLED Infinity O display with 90Hz refresh rate. This phone is powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 720G. Along with that, you will get a 6GB and 8GB of RAM options with 128GB as well as 256GB storage. And Samsung Galaxy A72 could also offer micro SD card support for expansion up to 1TB. Samsung Galaxy A72 also appears to have quad rear camera setup with a 64MP primary camera, 12MP of ultra wide angle camera and 5MP of macro shooter and 8MP of telephoto lens. And there would be around 5000mAh battery
with 25W charging.
And it was also offering around 32MP selfie sensor camera. Huawei P50 series will be the first to come with Harmony OS out of the box. Huawei P50 have completed the testing period of running Harmony OS 2.0 Beta 2 and it is moving on to Beta 3. The P50 will be the first phone to come with Harmony OS pre-installed. The interesting part is that P50 series will skip Android entirely. Amazon India expands Amazon food delivery service across 62 key locations in Bangalore. The service competes against the Swiggy and Zomato. Amazon Food can access on the Amazon app or by clicking on the food icon in the category bar. User can also search Amazon Food or by selecting Amazon Food under Shop by category. Prime members can get free delivery on all their orders while other customers will have to pay a delivery fee of Rs. 19 for their orders from Amazon Food. Amazon Food is available for ordering from 7 AM to 11 PM every day. Redmi K40 is expected to be rebranded as Poco F3 in global markets, probably including in India. It is already bagged the FCC certification and listed in IMEI database. Now phone has received the SIRIM certification with model number M2012K11AG in Malaysia, indicating Poco F3 Asia launch. It is not that too far away. Conversational AI firm GeoHaptic Technology today announced a strategic collaboration with customer service software firm Zendesk to help business transform customer experience and combine AI-driven automation with human-powered empathy. Haptic will act as a frontline of customer service to automate answering routine queries and improve first response time for business that use Zendesk. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.